Good afternoon all. My name is Femina and my topic is prevention of online transaction fraud using science and technologies evolving day by day and new inventions are being made all over the world. With the growing technology, lifestyles of human has also been changed. Can you move to the next slide? Earlier, people used to buy was sold in the market. People used to go out of the house to buy a number of things. But today, with the growing technology, everything was sold in online. Can you move the next slide? Okay. Due to this online shopping, people are attracted. Due to this, online transaction fraud has been also increased. Online transaction fraud comes into the category of internet fraud, where there is a use of internet service or software which internet assists to defraud victims or to otherwise take advantages of them. For example, by stealing personal information which include various credit details such as login, password, and other information, which ultimately leads to identity theft. The most common fraud is stealing credit card details. This is when the account number and PIN is hacked by malicious person or by group of hackers. In this paper, I implement the application which will detect the machine from which the transaction is done. In this, different machines are detected from which the transaction is done using same credit details. The location of the machine is also considered usually, and most of the time a person does the transaction regularly from the same device, which makes include home PC, laptop or smartphone. So there should be no need to confirm the person or user who is performing the transaction is a legitimate person, because he is doing the transaction from the regular device. If it is found that the transaction is initiating from different device, OTP will be generated and will be sent to the registered mobile number of the legitimate user. If the user is doing transaction from the regular device, but from another location, different from the previous transaction location, OTP will be generated. Next slide, please. Here I say about the types of online transaction fraud, credit card fraud, refund fraud, merchant fraud, card testing, friendly fraud, identity theft, phishing. First, we go through credit card fraud. When an unauthorized person gains access to your information and uses it to make purchases, fraudsters often make online purchases using stolen credit card details. They also gain all the information electronically. In refund fraud, it is a crime which involves returning good ineligible for refund to a retailer in exchange for money or other goods. Next slide, please. Can you move to the next slide?
Femina, we are on the next slide. Refund fraud, merchant fraud. You are after this?
Okay. Then we go through merchant fraud. It occurs when a fraudster poses as the merchant in order to process transaction and steal the funds. In this case, fraudsters using a stolen credit card and make an overpayment on purpose. Then card testing. It is a type of fraudulent activity where someone tries to determine if stolen card information can be used to make purchases. In card testing, it is a practice of creating and testing the validity of the credit card number in order to use it on another website to commit fraud. Then next slide, please. Friendly fraud. It is a type of chargeback fraud. It is also known as chargeback fraud. It is committed when an individual had knowledge of a transaction on their account, even though they reported it as an unauthorized. Then identity theft. It is the crime of obtaining the personal or financial information of another person to use their identity to commit fraud, such as making unauthorized transactions. Phishing. In this case, an email asks for user ID, password, credit card details, and other personal information. The sender seems to be a credit institution that needs a confirmation to some information due to a change in the system. Phishing allows criminals to get access to bank or other accounts, and it can be used to identity theft. Next slide, please. Okay. Percentage of online transaction fraud. In India, the customers have experienced 69% of fraud has been encountered in this. In India, 69% of fraud is encountered. Next slide, please. In this, I have said about dual-layer security mechanism. It is based on cookie-based prevention and location-based prevention. In cookie-based prevention, when user initiate transaction for the first time, cookies get generated on the user machine and OTP get generated. This cookie is specific to that user. If the same user again tries to initiate transaction from the same machine and same location, OTP will not be generated. Then location-based prevention. The system detects latitude and longitudinal wise location of user's machine from which the transaction is being initiated. The values obtained are then compared and matched with the location coordinate previously stored in the database. If these values match, then the system will not know that the transaction being initiated. The values obtained and they are compared and it is matched with the location and coordinate previously stored in the database. If this value is matched, the system will know that the transaction being initiated is legitimate and thus OTP will not be generated. Considering the same machine is being used to initiate the transaction from another location, then the coordinate will not match and the system will info that there is a change in location upon which the system will automatically generate the OTP. Next slide, please. Okay, working procedure. Working of the system with respect, I will explain below. At first, the system asks the user to get registered and then allows user to perform any transaction he wishes. After the user is registered, he can then initiate the transaction process. When user initiates the transaction for the first time, OTP is generated by the server and sent to the user's machine. The server generates user-specific cookies to the user's machine so that when user initiates transaction next time, OTP will not be generated. Considering that the user machine is located in the same location of the previous transaction, here the server first checks the cookies on the user's machine, and if the cookie for the particular transaction is obtained, then the server moves further and checks the location of the particular machine. The server then obtains the exact location of the user machine in the form of latitude and longitude. Then server then goes to the database to check whether there is a change in the user's location. This is done by comparing the location coordinate obtained by server with the location already present in the database. If a match is not found, then there is no change in the location and it gives free access to the user to perform the transaction that was initiated. But if in case the coordinates doesn't match, the system info that there has been a change in location and immediately generates an OTP to the mobile number of the user specified by registration. Thus, the system provides a dual-layer security mechanism with less or minimum for the user than the traditional system. Next slide, please. Next slide, please.
Okay, so we are on the prevention of online transaction fraud. You want me to move further?
Yeah. Okay. Prevention of online transaction fraud. Okay. How we have to prevent it? Stop believing unknown image. You should stop believing the images like chat, screenshot, etc. And then don't click on unknown attachment. Check the signs. Never share personal details. Beware of spyware. Protect your financial data. Use password or pins. Avoid sharing basic details. Don't download random apps. Ask others to use own details. Such this way, we have to prevent online transaction fraud. Then conclusion. Next slide, please. By using this application, we have added an extra layer of security in credit card transaction based on location. We have designed the application using which have an extra layer of security in credit card transaction, providing double security and thus a secure online transaction system for the further, not just online credit card and debit card transaction, but also transferring the funds from one account to the other securely. Similarly, the application proves effective not only to the customers, but also to the banks and can easily implement it on a real-time basis. Thank you all.